I met you in the dark, you lit me up. You made me feel as though I wasn't off. We danced the night away, we drank too much. I held your hair back when you were throwing up. Then you smiled over your shoulder. For a minute I was stone cold sober. I pulled you closer to my chest, and you asked me to stay over. I said I already told you, I think that you should get some rest. I knew I loved you then, but you'd never know it, 'cause I played it cool when I was scared of letting go. I knew I needed you, but I never show it. But I wanna stay with you until we're growing old. Just say you won't let go. Just say you won't let go. I'll wake you up with some breakfast in bed. I'll bring you coffee with a kiss on your head. I'll take the kids to school, wave them goodbye, and I'll thank my lucky stars for that night. When you looked over your shoulder, for a minute I forget that I'm older. I wanna dance with you right now. Oh, and you look as beautiful as ever, and I swear that every day you'll get better. You make me feel this way somehow. I'm so in love with you, and I hope you know, darling, your love is more than worth its weight in gold. We've come so far, my dear, look how we've grown. Ghost, 'cause you were always there for me when I needed you most. I'm gonna love you till my lungs give out. I promise till death we part, like in our vows. So I wrote this song for you. Now everybody knows that it's just you and me to a great love.
Thank you. Thank you. welcome everyone. As a quick reminder, please silence your phones for the remainder of the ceremony. Again, welcome to this joyous occasion. Thank you to everyone who made it today, especially thank you to those who are coming from far. David and Krystle especially want to thank everyone for coming here on a special day. Today, this beautiful and charming couple unite as one in marriage. Marriage is a promise between two people who love each other, who trust each other, who honor each other as individuals, and who wish to spend the rest of their lives together. Allow myself to introduce myself real quick. My name is Randy Mariano. I'm friends with both Dave and Krystle. For me, it is truly an honor that they asked me to be a part of this wedding. This is my first time ever officiating a wedding, so I apologize in advance if I stop. So I want to give a quick background on how I met Krystle and David. I met Krystle roughly 7 years ago or so through my wife, Rebecca. I don't know if Krystle remembers, but we were having a Taco Tuesday night at my house, and I remember thinking, this girl can talk a lot. I remember she laughs really loud and she's super happy. I remember asking Lily, is she drunk? But she wasn't. As I got to know Krystle, that's just the charm of her personality. She's always happy, she's so easy to talk to, and she's always alive at the party. I met Dave about 13 years ago, went to college together. He probably doesn't know this, but when I first met him, we were even friends. I saw him playing basketball. On the courts, and for those of you that don't know, David is really good. He doesn't have to pass the ball, but he's really good. But I just remember him dominating. He was just scoring on everybody, and he was actually pretty intimidating and a very imposing person. I never thought that eventually he would become a brother to me and one of my best friends. David Krystle's love story also began about 7 years ago. My wife also introduced them at some random party. But at the time, they were both relationships with other people. So the thought of them together never crossed any of our minds. But as the years went on, we found out without anybody knowing, they were chatting on Facebook and texting each other. And here's where the relationship developed. Now, if you ask them how they started dating or how they started becoming more than friends, they had a little bit, kind of different answers. When I asked Krystle, she said that David was so shy and too scared to ask her out. She knew that he liked her, but he was like a tender little puppy who couldn't muster up any courage. But if you asked Dave, he said that it was all part of his master plan. And he was just playing hard to get. Well, either way, they finally went on their first date. They went to the Gastro Club in Orange, and they hit it off well. And ever since then, they've been a very happy couple. Ever since David's been dating Krystle, I can see a positive change in him. She's brought the best in him. He's a more sensitive and tender individual. For those of you that don't know, her nickname for David is Boo Boo. I never thought of David as a boo-boo. But after I heard Krystle calling him that, he has a little smirk on his face. And David actually invites everyone for the rest of this evening to call him a boo-boo.
Marriage is one of life's greatest joys. But marriage also takes a lot of compromise and sacrifice.
And Krystle and David have done a lot of that for their future. Krystle moved at home. She gave over one of the Beamer, so to prepare for their future. And because of that, they were able to buy a beautiful home and were able to have this amazing wedding today. Dave also made some sacrifices. They would pick Krystle every day before work and drop off home. It was about an hour and a half drive one way, so 3 hours Dave would drive. Although the commute was long and he was tired, he did it for her. He let her sleep so she could rest. I have had the privilege to watch this relationship blossom throughout the years. I can honestly say, even though they've been dating for a while, that I still see the joy and fun they bring out in each other. When they're together, they are different.
but different in a good way. They laugh louder and they smile bigger. My wife, Lemmy, probably knows them best. She knew Krystle in high school, and she knew Dave in college. So I asked her what her thoughts on Dave and Krystle were. I think she summed up their relationship beautifully and perfectly. She said, "I know that they are truly and deeply in love with each other, but you can also tell that they truly are each other's best friends." And with that, I would like Jim, I'd like Jim to come up to do the lead. Jim, are you here?
Our reading from Ecclesiastes chapter 4, two are better than one, because they have a good return for their labor. If either of them falls down, one can help the other up. But if anyone falls, there's no one to help up. Also, if two lie down together, they will keep warm. But how can one keep warm alone? But one may be overpowered, two can defend themselves. A cord of three strands is not quickly broken.
Krystle and David, you fell in love by chance, but you either gave your risk or making a choice. You are both choosing each other. You have a choice to be with someone who makes you whole, who makes you think, makes you smile, and makes the day amazing for the promise of a new year if you invite it tomorrow.
I promise to love you in good times.
These things I give to you today. And all the days of our life.
And all the days of our life.
Yours is the wedding ring, the symbol of the relationship of love. The ring is symbolic of divine contract, to be given and received as part of everything love and devoted friendship. Circles of life and circles of love. May these rings always remind you of the vows that you have taken. David, will you please place this ring on the crystal and repeat after me? Krystle, I give you this ring.
Krystle, I give you this ring.
As a reminder, that I will love you, honor,
and cherish you,
in all times,
in all places,
and in all ways forever. David, I give you this ring.
As a reminder.
That I will love.
Honor.
And cherish you. In all times.
In all places.
And in all ways forever.
Family
friends. Today, Krystle and David have honored you all with an invitation to be present with them for the ceremony on this day that they better for all of us, that they should live together in marriage. We have watched them grow throughout the years, and they have built a relationship of deepest love and trust for one another. We have witnessed them making the vows and promises, and have given them the symbols and rings of commitment to one another. Therefore, it is my great pleasure that I now pronounce to you husband and wife, David and his bride.
Magic in the air. Hips are toes so bare.
someday. When I'm awfully low, when the world is cold, I will feel a glow just thinking of you and the way you look tonight. Oh, but you're lovely. With your smile so warm and your cheek so soft, there is nothing for me but to love you. Just the way you look tonight.
I just wanted to say thank you all for being here and gathering around today to celebrate the union of David and my sister, Krystle. Ever since I can remember, all I ever wanted to do is just be like my sister, my ate. I wanted to dress like her. I wanted to twirl flags like her in high school. So I tried out for the team, and it probably helped that she was captain that year. Otherwise, I probably would not have made the team. You know, home furnishings wasn't always the coolest thing to me, but when Ata got a job there, I was like, I gotta work at the Pottery Barn. So I just look up to her a lot. I know at my wedding she kind of said that I was the brighter one, but she's always the one that I've looked up to in life. And it says a lot about someone's character, especially if they have friends that stay with them throughout the years. So as you can tell, a lot of the people in her bridal party are people that she's known since middle school.
Yeah!
So, Suzanne, yeah, represent. And Randy touched on a lot of things about Krystle's character and David's character. I first met David in 2012 on one of my visits back to California, and I knew right away that he was a good fit. I knew especially that this was going to be a lasting relationship when my sister gave up her BMW. She's always had one, and I'm sure maybe down the line that might re-enter their lives. But I just want to wish them well, and I know that it means a lot to me to see her welcomed into the Tran family, and I know that she loves and adores you guys. And so I just want to say congratulations to you both. I wish you a lifetime of happiness. I learned that David, like me, is a procrastinator. So David, just to let you know, there is this thing called the biological clock that's ticking in these.
That's later tonight.
JC, I'm sure, would like a cousin, and I would love some nieces and nephews. So everyone raise a glass and toast to the new Mr. and Mrs. Tran.
Hey guys, I don't know if you remember me, but I'm Randy. I just officiated the wedding, so hello. I used a lot of my good material for the ceremony, so I don't know what to say, but I do want to say that, you know, Dave's been a really good friend to me. I think we always got along because we always had so much in common. One thing that we really brought us close together was basketball. You know, like I said, Dave, out of all of our friends, he's the best player. He's always been like the man, and I've been the sidekick. Dave's been the Jordan, I've been the Pippen. Dave's been the Shaq, I've been the Kobe. Yeah. Yeah. Right? But we used to be a lot better. We were a lot thinner and cuter back in the day. But then we got fat. But we're still pretty good, so every now and then we'll be on fire making shots, and you'll hear the other team say, "Don't let those two fat guys shoot." And I know they're talking about us, so thanks, Dave. But no, in all seriousness, Dave has been a really good friend to me. I know a lot of times you have friends, and sometimes the friendships either plateau or you lose contact. But with Dave, I really feel that every year our friendship grows and we fall deeper in love with each other, you know? So so thank you, Dave, for always being there for me, and I know you'll make a great husband. To Krystle, you look amazing tonight. So, you know, Krystle's always been, like I said, super fun, super nice, always the life of the party. But I want to thank you because I don't know if you guys know, but Krystle is the godmother to my son, Maddox. And for that, I will always consider you family and love you. You treat him like he's your own, and I will always be grateful to you. So if everyone could please raise their glass. To Dave and Krystle, I wish you a life of love, happiness, and Laker championships. Woo! Got Mike? Let's give Randy my applause one more time.
Wait, be honest.
Sorry.
But she is, no, it's fine.
It's
all good, it's all good. But you're ready. That's the kind of guy I like. Look at that. But round of applause for Ray Senior, everybody.
Let us stand, everybody. This is a blessing for the newlyweds, and so we'll pray, and this is what I know, and all faith needs spirituality, so this one is for her, for the couple. Jesus, Mary, and Joseph, in you we contemplate the splendor of true love, to you we turn with trust and confidence. We present to you our newly married couple, Krystle Francis Chu and David Lam Tran. Bless them and be with them always. May this newlywed Krystle and David always experience peace and love, and may never experience violence, rejection, and division. May they always console each other and be of great support in times of need. help them to care for each other and establish an everlasting bond of love. Holy Family of Nazareth, may Krystle and David once more be mindful of the sacredness of the marriage and family and its beauty of God's plan. Help Krystle and David keep walking together. May they understand that marital and family spirituality is made up of thousands of small but real gestures. Remember, no family drops down from heaven perfectly performed. Family needs constantly to grow and mature and loving each other. We are human and cannot expect to be perfect or to be loved perfectly. Your love for one another must be freely and generously expressed in words and acts. Both of you may realize that wedding ceremony is not the end of the road, but instead embark upon marriage as a lifelong calling, based on a firm and realistic decision to face and trials and difficult moments all together. Holy Family of Nazareth, grant that our newly formed family may be a place of communion and prayer, authentic school of the gospel in small domestic church. May this newly married couple never lose heart because of their limitations, or ever stop seeking that fullness of love and communion with God holds out before us. Remember, trust creates better homes. Build up your trust and confidence in one another and create the better home. May Almighty God bless you, may the angels protect you, and may the Holy Family of Nazareth be always your model and guide. Jesus, Mary, and Joseph, graciously hear our prayer. Amen.
Amen.
Grace for the before meals. So we're gonna eat after this. Bless us, O Lord, and these thy gifts, which we are about to receive from thy bounty, through Christ our Lord. Amen.
The groom, David's family side.
Give him the business.
I'd like to introduce David's parents, Mr. and Mrs. Tran. David's sister, Queenie, and her husband, Ken. David and Frank Taylor. One. Uncle Don from Canada. Yeah! Uncle and Nan, Len, Lam, and Yo. And now we're going to introduce David's cousin. David has lost a cousin. I tell you what. I tell you what. All David's cousins, they all love him. And they all support him. Okay? So, I'm going to introduce the oldest cousin and then the youngest one. Cousin and Lee. Yeah. His wife couldn't be here tonight. Sorry about that. Cousin and Max and his wife, Jo. Cousin from Canada, Jeto and her husband Lenny. Cousin and ex and his wife, cousin and half and his wife, Sorry about that. I apologize. Really sorry about that. Uncle Don, have a little bit of drink. Okay? The next one. Cousin Deb and her husband Yong from San Jose. Cousin and half and his wife, yeah. Here we go. Cousin Antong and his wife, we have from Canada. Cousin Emily and her husband Peter. Cousin Ikan. Cousin Shirley and husband Scott. Cousin Angie and his wife Jessica. Cousin Vicky and her husband Steve. Cousin Angie and his wife Angela. Cousin Kevin and Liam. Cousin Van from Canada. Cousin Pao. This will be the last cousin, the youngest in the family. Vinny, David.
Dalton and David.
Thank you very much, you guys. Enjoy the party.
I'm David's sister, Queenie. Welcome to the wedding, and we appreciate and are grateful for you to be here, especially in the rain on a cold November day. But your presence here really warm up the room, so thank you for that too. Well, I'm truly honored to be here and share a few things about my brother, Krystle. My brother David and his wife Krystle. So there are three things that I wanted to share about my brother first. One of the thing is my brother is one of my brother's great quality is that he has a huge heart, and from as long as I can remember, he's always been caring and giving, and has such an amazing soul. He's incredibly forgiving and cares about others. I know this because I'm his sister. And growing up, I actually used to bully him. I used to boss him around all the time. But yet, he puts up with me, he forgives me, he serves me, he treats me so well by kindness. He even tried to protect me stands up for me from kids who are twice his size. So he has a big heart. Second, I don't know anyone who loves the Lakers more than my brother does. As kids, we used to wake up super early at 7 a.m. just to get autographs from NBA Laker players several times. One of the times I've seen my brother most depressed and sad was in 2004 when I walked into a room. He didn't eat dinner, he was in bed, he couldn't get out of bed. It's because the Lakers lost to the Pistons in 2004 championship. He was really depressed. So my brother is truly a Laker fan, and his passion for the Laker is real. Third, I most admire about my brother's perseverance and his ability to finish what he starts at. When he puts his mind to something and he's determined to do it, not only finish it, but do it well. I've seen him persevere through the years and work hard at what he does, and I really admire him for that. Whether it's through finishing the crazy sporting races, or watching whole seasons of Friends, or climb up his career, I've always admired David's determination to finish things and really do the best he can. So these are the three things I want to share with my brother tonight. What I am amazed is that he actually found a counterpart that shares the same thing. My sister, my new sister, Krystle. So, on behalf of our family, we want to welcome Krystle to our family. She's not only a new sister that I've always wanted, but she's also JC's new aunt, who's loving, kind, and thoughtful. David and Krystle, sorry, he's getting heavy. David and Krystle, my husband Ken, and I, we want to share some wisdom from our marriage that we've learned these past few years. First, if you communicate to one another through tough issues and resolve things, it will only draw you closer together. Second, never let that dorkiness and the child heart in you grow old, because that helps the spark keep going. And finally, JC told me that he can't wait to have a new cousin. Yeah. brother and new sister. Congratulations, and we're so proud of you. God bless.
Yo, boo boo! We love you, boo boo!
So, congratulations, David and Krystle. I've known Krystle since she was a baby, since she was in her diapers, and I used to take care of her when she was really young, and then now I've seen her grown into a beautiful young lady. So me and Krystle had a lot of good memories together. When we grew up together, we actually used to shop all the time together, and there were a lot of times we used to wear the same clothes, and there were moments when we would have to tell each other, let's coordinate, make sure we're not wearing the same things, because we're always shopping and buying the same things. And then I used to live with her when I was in college, and Krystle and I, we were sharing a room, and then she would always wake me up because I would fall asleep studying, and she would just laugh at me because I was drooling in my books. And so I was happy. She was my alarm clock, actually. I made it to school many times. But anyways, regardless of that, all our memories I will always remember because she's like a little sister to me. And sorry. So when she told me about David, I knew there was something different about him, that he was special. So very special. They had a lot of things in common, but things that were also different. But I knew when Krystle told me about David and that they were together, that she was just so happy, and I could see the glow in her eyes. And I saw David also just being such a wonderful, kind person, and they matched so well together. And I knew that they were kind of the perfect balance, because Krystle likes to eat, loves French fries, loves her baked potatoes, shopping, and good quality items. David is practical and likes likes different things than Krystle, but they balance each other very well. And I think they're just the perfect match, and I'm just so happy that David is part of our family now. And with that, congratulations and cheers to you guys.
All right, I hope it's actually my turn this time. All right, hello everybody. My name is Maros Beloch. I'm one of David's best friends. I'd just like to welcome everybody to this wedding. And for my Vietnamese-speaking guests, Ginh Giao Gui Vi. And for my Tagalog-speaking guests, Malagayang Pagdating Sa Kasal. Now, I hope I didn't say anything offensive if I mispronounced the words or anything like that. Again, I'd like to thank all the family and friends for attending this wedding. I've known David for a long time, for 14 years. And like a lot of people, a lot of the guys that you'll meet over here, we met on the basketball court. And, you know, David's a big guy, and I'm a big guy, so we faced off against each other. And it was the most epic battle you'll ever see. Imagine Godzilla versus King Kong, right? And to be honest, I hated David because he was probably one of the few guys that was just as good as me, and and I couldn't beat him. And he was scoring at will on me, and I was like, man, I never want to see this guy again. And then next week, he shows up to the same fraternity I joined. And with that, we just started playing basketball together, and our friendship blossomed from being teammates on the basketball court to me being his best man. And in fact, he's been an incredibly loyal friend. He was there with me when I got punched by a pregnant lady on Black Friday. That was 10 years ago, so now I'm looking for that 10-year-old kid who was in the womb at the time. But David's just an incredibly loyal guy. I know I can count on him for everything. And Krystle, there's not enough time in the program today to talk about Krystle. Like, honestly, the second I met Krystle, I knew she was perfect for David. I mean, I know it's a very cliched statement, but you can actually believe it when you meet Krystle. I've seen David grow so much as a person. Because, I mean, before, when it's just me and David, what do we talk about? Basketball, Lakers, not Star Wars. I've tried to make David watch Star Wars, and he's the most frustrating individual in the world, right? There's 6 episodes of Star Wars, he started on episode 5, and you're not supposed to do that. Then he went back to episode 2, and then he's just jumping around, and he knows how much I like Star Wars, and he's doing it on purpose just to piss me off. Okay? That being said, I mean, going back to Krystle, I mean, she's made David, like I was saying, with me and David, it's about basketball, gadgets, this and that, technology, and shoes. Yeah, we can go on about that. But Krystle's honestly made David more of he's not the best in showing affection. So all of these kissing in front of everybody, you see, I mean, he's doing it because he loves Krystle. So he's definitely, you know, grown as a man. I know he'll make a great husband, and hopefully soon a great father as well. Now, I've only been married for 1 year to my lovely wife, right over here. She made sure I gave her a shout out when I came up here. So that was it right there. So I don't have much wisdom, as she can attest to, in terms of being married yet. So I'm not gonna try to give you guys any advice at this point, but this is such a multicultural event. You know, we have different cultures being united today. So I wanted to share something from the Pakistani culture with Krystle and David. So if Krystle and David, if you guys can hold hands and hold it up. So this represents the unity between a man and a woman and as they come to their marriage. Krystle, if you could put your hand over it. This showed the bond and the strength that the wife brings in holding the family together. And David, can you put your hand on top? And this is the last time David will have the upper hand. And if you could all raise your glasses to Krystle and David, may they have a lovely life together and full of joy and happiness.
My bones, it goes electric wavy when I turn it on. Off from my city, off from my home, we're flying up no ceiling when we in our zone. I got that sunshine in my
ready.
As I was saying, I wish I saw you guys more in the past and like spent time with like the other side of the family, but I just want you guys to know that I love you guys so much and I'm so happy that you guys are together, and I hope that we get to spend more time together in the future, because I'm just happy you guys are happy.
Got that good soul in my feet. I feel that hot blood in my back.
steady when it drops. Ooh, I can't take my eyes off of it. Moving so phenomenally. You're more like the way we rock it. So don't stop that. You when you dance, dance, dance. Feel a good, good creeping up on you. So just